For as long as humanity has existed, the night sky has called to us. When we look out into that vast darkness, what exactly are we looking at? Is it an endless, lifeless expanse? A reminder that in a sprawling universe, we are, in the end, all alone? Or is it a gateway to life elsewhere in the universe, to civilizations as yet unknown? In other words, when we look up at the night sky, is someone out there looking back? It's one of the most profound questions that mankind can ask. And the answer involves a llama. A dead llama. The year was 1947. The place was Washington State, and the prevailing mood was holy shit. That was the year that the pilot of a small plane reported seeing something unprecedented. 9 shiny, unidentifiable objects flying in formation. And when descriptions of these objects as flying saucers started hitting the media, we were off to the races. In the years since, there have been more than 170,000 sightings of mysterious objects in the sky. By the 1960s, there were starting to be reports of alien abductions. In the first one, by the way, it was reported that the aliens got an authentic welcome to Earth when the couple in question tried to shoot them. And today, belief in aliens is so mainstream as to have become the majority position. As of 2021, 51% of Americans told pollsters that they believe reports of UFOs are likely evidence of extraterrestrial visitors. Which you can kind of understand. After all, we've got about 75 years worth of these kinds of stories. And with even government officials admitting in recent years that they can't explain every incident, it's no wonder that people are at least open-minded. Except, you often don't hear the other part, where the government also reports that there's never been any evidence to suggest that any of this is aliens. And sure, maybe this is a topic on which you don't want to blindly trust what the feds say, but they're not exactly alone. Those flying saucers back in the 1940s, almost certainly top-secret balloons designed to monitor Soviet weapon activity. All those sightings since? A 2023 study that analyzed nearly 100,000 of them found that they were disproportionately likely to happen in places with a clear view of the night sky, that were near military bases, or airports, which likely means that if we were seeing aliens, they were flying southwest. Alien corpses, like the two that were supposedly unveiled before the Mexican parliament in 2023, a CT scan revealed that those remains were, in part, the skull of a llama. Though, to be fair, we don't know for sure what planet the llama was from. And more broadly, a lot of the imprecision here seems awfully convenient. After all, we live in a country where 90% of people walk around with a camera in their pocket all the time. And yet, no one has ever gotten a clear shot of a UFO? And what about all those supposedly crashed spacecraft? Do we really think aliens have mastered interstellar travel, but their GPS just goes haywire when they hit New Mexico? But here's where things get tricky. The question of whether or not flying saucers or alien abductions are real isn't quite the same as the question as to whether there might be life elsewhere in the universe. In other words, the truth probably isn't out there, but it might be out there. Here's what we mean. The universe is really large. In our galaxy alone, there are at least 100 billion stars, most with at least one planet orbiting around them. And by the way, our galaxy is only one of approximately 2 trillion, which means there are a lot of places that life could be. Now, with all due respect to the people who are mummifying llamas or firing pistols at their intergalactic kidnappers, if we really want to wrap our heads around this, we ought to ask how likely scientists think it is that there's life elsewhere in the universe. And the answer to that question is, well, It's complicated. Ever since the 1960s, scientists have had a framework for how to think through this question. It's called the Drake equation, and it's pretty straightforward. You simply multiply the rate of formation of stars suitable for the development of intelligent life by the fraction of those stars with planetary systems, by the number of planets per solar system with an environment suitable for life, by the fraction of suitable planets on which life actually appears, by the fraction of life-bearing planets on which intelligent life emerges, by the fraction of civilizations that develop a technology that produces detectable signs of their existence, by the average length of time such civilizations produce such signs, and voila. You get the number of civilizations in the Milky Way galaxy whose electromagnetic emissions are detectable. See? Simple. Oh, also, we should mention, of these seven variables that go into this equation, we only know how to calculate one of them. And as a result, the estimates for how many of these civilizations exist run from millions to... it's just us. And for the record, this is not us making fun of the Drake equation. This is us telling you that even the best scientific thinking on this question only gets you an educated guess. And sometimes, it only gets you more questions. That's the case with the Fermi paradox, the famous quandary posed by the physicist Enrico Fermi in 1950. Given the significant likelihood that there is life out there somewhere, and given how old the universe is, which means that aliens would have had more than enough time to travel across it, where is everybody? And the variety of proposed answers to that question is truly wild. There's the zoo hypothesis, in which aliens have decided to treat Earth like a wildlife preserve and are just leaving us alone. There's the replacement hypothesis, which supposes that life forms in other parts of the universe are so advanced that they've already replaced themselves with robots, who, in turn, have no interest in human beings. There's even one called the dark forest hypothesis, which suggests that the universe is so dangerous that any aliens would intentionally keep quiet, because making your presence known would almost certainly lead inhabitants of other planets to destroy you. But we've already established that Americans shoot aliens, so we should be in the clear on that one. Whether we're alone in the universe is one of the consuming questions of humanity. And we're getting more places to look all the time. In just the last 30 years, we've discovered over 5,600 planets outside of our solar system. And with new technologies like NASA's stunning James Webb Space Telescope, we'll be able to study their atmospheres and learn more than we could have ever dreamed about whether the building blocks of life exist elsewhere in space. What does that mean for the future? We don't yet know. Maybe we'll just never discover the answer. Or maybe there's really nothing else out there. Or maybe, just maybe, the universe will reveal that... okay, we owe those dudes in Mexico an apology.